Rapid County School Board. As always, we will begin with 90-second opening statements by each of the candidates, followed by rapid questions, and then again, closing statements by each of the candidates. Thank you all, first of all, for your participation tonight. Looking forward to a lively discussion. We will get started with an opening statement by Mr. Teddy Bryson.
My name is Teddy Bryson. I'm a lifelong resident of Rapid County. I personally thank all the people that are putting this information out there to the public. I won't name all of it because I leave somebody out. I grew up in Rapid County. I attended the Rapid County School, graduated from Rapid High School in 1966, had perfect attendance. Told Bradley Murray at the Cleveland State Championship, their state tournament. I had to go. Had missed one, but didn't plan on missing one. All missed it as too. Enjoyed it, except we got beat. Won a few times the bracket got beat. Jane Rock was sick that day, so I know about Rapid County. My brothers taught Rapid County schools. I grew up here, as I said. I taught every grade level, our supervisor every grade level, pre-K through 12. I was principal of Oak Grove School for 18 years. You can ask my teachers about me if you don't know me. I've tried to do that every member in the third district. If I haven't got to you yet, I'll be there. I'm walking the streets if you haven't seen me, and I believe that's the way to make it public. I work hard. I work hard for you. As I said, you asked my teachers. I want to say one thing. If I run out of time, I'll finish it at the end. I want to let you know real quick, school is not a business. We teach all kids. Rich kids, poor kids, black kids, white kids, kids with ADHD, kids with non-English speaking, you name them, we teach them. Tall kids, skinny kids, you name them, we teach them. We can't send them back like business people can. If they get a piece of numbers that ain't good, they send it back. We can't. School is not a business.
I'm Charlie Rose. I ran for the school board 8 years ago, and I was elected, and I've enjoyed serving you and the people of Bradley County School. We find ourselves in Bradley County, like many school boards do, trying to really define the role since the position of director of schools was changed to appointed instead of elected. It really placed a great deal of responsibility on the school boards and how they respond to the public. The school board is the link between what happens in the Bradley County schools and what the public wants to happen in Bradley County schools. They foot the bill. They pay the bill. I respond to the public. I love Bradley County schools. It's a good school system. I served about 40 years in it. Now I've been on the board 47, 48 years. And I want to emphasize how important it is that the board communicates to the public what happens in their schools and what we are doing with your money and what we want you to understand. We want to hear from you what we should do, how you want us to spend your money. We have changed many things in the last 8 years. One of those things is we have put more, the board puts more time, more effort, and deals with things. Thank you. I'll pick up later.
For 4 years, our school system has been under attack from the federal government, from special interests, from corporations, from the state government, from unions. This board has not fallen apart during that time. It has come together. It has come together as a board, and it has come together with the county commission. We are now working as a team. My opponent wants to take us back to where we were 4 years ago, back to using test scores to decide whether a teacher gets fired or not, back to when Common Core was being implemented. I'm Nicholas Lilios, your representative to the 3rd District, a lifelong Republican, and I'm moving forward.
I'm Nancy Kaysen. I'm running for Bradley County School Board District 1, Hopewell, Prospect, and McDonald. I currently own a small business downtown called the Red Ribbon. I've had it since 2005. Prior to that, my late husband, Flavis Kaysen, and I had 3 businesses going. We had Kaysen Art and Interiors, which was an international organization that sold all over the world, framed art, bedspreads, drapes, sofas, whatever you needed done in your facility, we did, except we didn't paint your walls and we didn't fix your floors. But we were also a government contractor. We had several GSA numbers. At the same time, we have a furniture manufacturing company in Polk County called Reliance Furniture. We tore down old barns over 100 years old, used that lumber and made antique reproduction furniture, which again, we shipped all over the world. And at the same time we were doing that, we had a small business in Guatemala City, Guatemala, where we had some architectural students from the university there painting large canvases that we put in hotels all over the world. Prior to that, I was a teacher in McMinn County Schools. I taught in the classroom and I taught special education. I left education in 1987, several years ago, so I could join my husband in our business where I was a full partner. I'm certified to do everything from K through 12 teaching, certified to be a principal, certified to be a supervisor, and I love education, and that is why I'm up here tonight to talk to you about my possibility of serving you on the Bradley County School Board.
Good evening. I'd like to first of all thank all of you for hanging out this lovely temperature. I'd like to thank my wife and her family for being here with us. I'd like to thank my kids for being here tonight. My name is Chris Turner. I am your current representative on the County School Board for the First District. I'm also the current chairman of the school board. I'm very proud that your Board of Education finally got serious about strategic planning. That strategic plan has unified our board, our director of schools, our central office, and our school system. And that strategic plan puts families and students first. I am a proud product of Bradley County Schools. I graduated from Bradley Central in 1990. My wife and I met in chemistry class a few years ago. Next month, we celebrate our 23rd wedding anniversary. I'm the son of the late Sue Turner, who gave her life teaching in our school system. She taught geometry to thousands upon thousands of people in this community. My wife is a teacher in our school system. My three kids started kindergarten at a First District school. They started at Hopewell. They've gone all the way to Walker Valley. My youngest will be a senior in high school. I live the Bradley County Schools experience. I know what families experience firsthand. I'm a deacon at North Lakeland Baptist. I teach the love of Jesus Christ to elementary school boys. I teach how to take the message of Christ around the world. I love this community. I love our school system. And later, I'm sure we're going to answer some questions about all the things that we've done about taxes. Without new taxes, without new spending. I'm a faithful Republican. I didn't show up because it's election season. I've served in this community, and I will continue to serve if you'll elect me. Thank you.
I'm Jerry Frazier, and there's not anything in the school business that I have not done except serve on school board. I was a teacher coach for 7 years. I was a principal for 7 years, assistant principal for 10 years, superintendent for 8 years, a lead teacher for 10 years. I've led accreditation teams all over Tennessee and all over Georgia, helping schools get accredited and improve their programs. I am passionate about schools. There's never been a time when I wasn't. I grew up, I was born one block south of here. I grew up where Pocoy and Broad run together down across from what is now Fire Hall Number 1, then it was Templeton Hill School. I played in the schoolyard from the time I was big enough to walk. Bill Schultz is my elementary principal. When I got to Bradley, he was my high school principal. 3 years later, he hired me to be a teacher, so he's my first boss. But I've always loved schools and loved teachers, and if you improve schools, that's where you do it, is in classrooms. I believe that energy is extremely important. It doesn't matter if you're hiring a custodian or a principal or whomever. The energy that they can bring to that task is critical to getting those jobs done. Schools reflect the communities they serve, and there's no doubt about that. The mission of Bradley County Schools in partnership with parents and the community is to develop literate, creative, self-confident citizens capable of meeting life challenges, and we've been doing a good job of that in Bradley County for a long time. Hope to continue doing it.
All right, we'll start with you. What do you see as the biggest issue facing Bradley County Schools, and why?
Did you ask that? In my opinion, is the mismanagement of taxpayers' money. First example, the dismissal or ouster of Tony McDaniels that cost anywhere from $150 to $250 million. That's a lot of money. Could hire a lot of teachers. Could give them the teachers as much as their raises instead of the 10 cents they're getting this year. I also know my opponent, front page Cleveland Daily Banner. If you want to see a copy, I have it. You can look it up online. Let me raise your taxes 28 cents per hundred.
or 50%. Again, that's a lot of money, but not if you're rich. I would oppose raising those taxes. They're changing the great ways to save money, changing the reading program in the middle of adoption. I don't know how much that's going to cost. Might be a good idea, but we all know how much taxpayers, I don't know what it's costing. We chose the highest bid for cleaning service. Again, might be a good idea, but why? Because we not chose the lowest bid and save taxpayers money. Cutting teachers for pet projects, our peers, my opponent and others are more interested in going out and buying buildings than they are educating children. I love Brady County. I'm not against anybody. And most important thing I'd like to see done is my opponent to go to the House and be to take his place. Simple as that. I didn't say he's a bad businessman. He's a great businessman, but he's not a good educator.
What I think is so important in Brady County schools at this time is to build community support for our school system. We have operated several years as a closed school system. We do not welcome the public when they came to our school, they came to the central office. They do it at schools, because I worked out there, I know how it works. It took me a while to visualize what it was like when I moved on the board and went and operated in the central office part of it. You know, they were not a welcoming center for the public. They closed. They would not give information to the public when they needed it. They wouldn't give any information to the board members when they needed it. They distributed it to the people they wanted to have it. And not every board member, was there and got the information at the same time. How can a board member make good decisions if they don't have the proper information?
The biggest issue facing Bradley County students is literacy. 48% of our kids in third grade are not meeting the third grade level. My opponent has been there for 40 years. He should know this. Reed 20, our new director, has led a program to reach 90% literacy in Bradley County over the next 5 years. That is the big issue. If you can't read, how are you going to succeed in life? How are you going to read the instructions? How are you going to read your handbook when you start your first job? How are you going to make it to college? How are you going to make it in the military? Literacy. That is the big issue. Kids need to be able to read at grade level by third grade.
I think there's two issues that we need to look at, and one of them I think is finance, and I think the funds are there. My question is, how have they been spent? And are they being spent the way that they need to be spent for the betterment of our students? The second one that really, really concerns me, and it's from things I've heard in the community, is the morale of our teachers. Right now, the morale of our teachers may be the lowest that it has ever been, and that's a shame. And having been a teacher 40-plus years ago, I'll tell you, if you're not happy in your job as a teacher, and I'm not saying make everything ha-ha-ha, but I am saying if they're not comfortable and they're not pleased with the situation they're in, it's going to reflect on the education that they do with their students, and that's going to show up, and that is a shame. And I think it is a real shame that the morale of our teachers is what it is right now in Bradley County. Thank you.
After listening to the city council and the other forums, it's difficult to be at the end of the line and say something new. But I'm going to actually break a barrier here. The biggest issue that we have in Bradley County schools is the fact that we're, for the first time in decades, in a place that we can actually make investment. One of the other candidates talked about spending $250,000 in a buyout of the director. It was actually $140,000. That was the real number. And since today is the last day of the fiscal year, I'll tell you that we will save taxpayers this year no less than $1.4 million this year. After paying that buyout, after investing in new roofs and windows and air conditioning units, oh, and by the way, we put iPads in the hands of K-1 and 2 in Prospect, the first district school, and Valley View, the sixth district school, to help with literacy as a function of our strategic plan. The biggest issue we have is the best opportunity, and that's what strategic planning can do, is it can flip the tables on how we look at what's in front of us. We can talk about problems and argue and fight. Sorry, I've been there. It's not even fun. This board is united behind that strategic plan, and the best opportunity we have is how are we going to invest. And that's the future of Bradley County Schools.
The single biggest thing in schools today are as far as the effectiveness of schools, is teachers, and technology. Obviously, I agree to a great extent with several things that have been said. The most critical thing for students in K-2 is learning to read. And then they read to learn. And so I applaud the Read 20 program. We started the Accelerated Read program back when I was superintendent. It still exists today and has caused a lot of good things to occur. A lot of kids' reading scores to get better. Happy teachers are better teachers. A shade tree mechanic can fix your car one time with two screwdrivers and a wrench. You better have some tools today, computers. And teachers are no different. A great teacher can teach something under an oak tree. But how much more can they do with a full toolbox, the technology that's available out there today to help them get through to the various learning styles that kids have? Teachers need to feel supported.
Next question, start with Mr. Frazier going down the way. What will you do to support a school culture that embraces students who identify with the LGBT community?
Well, I've always thought that there are hardly any school issues, educational issues that can't be solved if you have committed teachers and caring parents. So, obviously, schools are diverse, as Mr. Bryson said. We take all the kids and all the people, and they come from different backgrounds, different faiths, different belief systems, and they all deserve our very best. And we need to take them where they are as far as we possibly can. So, obviously, when you have an issue, you deal with that issue. And so that's where I stand with regard to that. Whatever issues come up, you face them and you meet them and you deal with it to the satisfaction of the people that are involved.
Make sure I understand the question. You asked the question, what will we do to support a school culture?
A school culture that embraces students who identify with LGBT community.
See,
with their concerns.
Serving on the school board the last 4 years, I've seen it with all kinds of issues. This is just another one, what I'm sure is going to be a long string of issues, where the school system is supposed to somehow regulate, is somehow supposed to be the moral authority. I'm sorry, but that responsibility belongs in the home. The school system is there to teach content, learning methods, instruction, history, all kinds of things. But we're not there to tell a kid whether you're a boy or a girl, whether you identify one thing or the other. So what we do as a school system is about teaching. Now, a culture that creates hostility, that's not cool. That's bullying. And it doesn't matter if it's LGBT, it doesn't matter if it's religion, it doesn't matter what it is. We can't allow that to happen because it impacts the ability of kids to learn. But as far as building a school culture to drive that agenda, that's not our job. And it's certainly not consistent with the values that people are representing.
I think this is one of those situations that law will come down and say, this is what you have to do. But I think also for us in this community, it's going to be something that we would have to personally address. As a special education teacher, years ago, I found that you had to address all kinds of situations for students that were special. Now, it wasn't this kind of special, but they were special, and they had to be addressed. And I think that as a school board, we need to support our teachers who have to address this situation, our principals who have to address this situation, should the situation arise.
Respect and protect the child. He is a child. This has just now come to the media forefront, but our school system has already dealt with these issues, and we've done it discreetly, respectfully, and that's how it should remain.
Beyond the school system, it's been to meet individual needs since I walked into the Bradley County Schools since 1969. And I dealt with individual needs every day. The idea was to meet those needs and to move on. Every child is equal. Every child should be treated the same. Every child should be protected. Every child should be in a safe environment. Schools deal with that every day. And I know we have dealt with the issues that are at hand. It's just the national people have decided to send it on down. Well, I'm ready as a board member. Bring it on. I will make decisions that are ethically correct, that will address children's individual needs, and it will reflect the culture of Bradley County Schools, Bradley County community.
As I said earlier, I will answer this question. That's a very important question in today's climate. But I want to remind teachers, our people, you guys, the teachers all across school, we were never on the list of state kids. Our kids could read, not all of them, but most of them. Our teachers work hard. I think some of the best in the world, I think. Hard-working teachers. So they did address it. I did address it. Bradley County Schools educated three of my children. One graduated from Lincoln Memorial University with a degree in environmental science. One is a doctor here in Bradley County, and one is a lawyer in Chattanooga. So they did a pretty good job in Bradley County Schools. Oak Grove does a good job. I can name all kinds of famous people that graduated from there, but everybody else. But since you never attended the county schools, you wouldn't know. Now, on that issue that you brought up, the law will dictate a lot of that. We've always had some of that. I have no problem dealing with anybody. I've never had a problem. Homeschool kids, black kids, white kids, we don't care who. Send them to us, we'll educate them. And that includes our gay friends that want to attend our schools. They do a good job. They're students, they're taxpayers. And again, I support the right to go to school. I support the right to the best education they can get, and they will be treated fairly in Bradley County School. I say whether I'm on the board or not.
This next question is a loaded question. By that I mean it just got a lot of content. It more or less combines a number of the questions that were submitted. So follow me when I read it. Are the educational needs of our community being met by our current funding model? If yes, why? If no, why? And what is the solution to bring more funding to the table in the way of increasing revenues in the form of tax increases or by making cuts to budgets to pay for these needs? And I think we'll start over here.
First, could we do a better job? Yes, we could. Our teachers do the best job they can. Yes. On funding, we could quit wasting our money for one thing. I don't know if it's $100,000 or $300,000, but where I grew up, that's still a lot of money. It might not be a lot of money to some of these people, but the taxpayers, it is. Changing the reading program, that's a lot of money. We could do a lot of things with the money, to fund the system. I save the money. Why didn't teachers get a raise for that? It would have helped her morale a whole lot. And I'm telling you now, I'm opposed to the tax increase. I've never wanted tax increases. I'm not saying there couldn't be, you couldn't convince me. I'm opposed to war. But I'm not saying, I served in the military, by the way, as most people up here did not. And that's okay. I served so they could run, so they could be in freedom. And I'm telling you now that I oppose tax increases. I've always opposed tax increases. But I'm not saying that you couldn't convince me that it's possible to have it. Just like you could convince me to go to war. You might.
Not responsibility of the Bradley County School Board to set tax rates and to do things of that nature. It's our responsibility to communicate to the public our needs and what we are doing. And then it will be left up to the public and the people in the powering positions, this is on the county commission, to set tax rates and to give us an increase in funding. You know, that is not our responsibility. Our responsibility is to take what we have and do the very best we can with it. And we have done things in the last 4 years that has improved the spending practices of Bradley County Schools. Otherwise, we would not have ended up with a $820,000 excess of the money we had budgeted for that year. Also, Bradley County teachers did get a raise. It was not across the board.
On this issue, half the people are mad all the time. If you say you want to cut some programs to save money, you got every teacher and every parent in the school system calling you and giving you grief over it. If you say, okay, let's look at raising taxes so we can have everything we want, and you get the other half of the population saying they don't want to pay another cent, one more red cent in taxes. So what do you do as a board member? You open discussion. You bring it up. You say, how about a cut, like I did in my first year on the board? What if we put money into savings instead of going into debt to pay for our infrastructure? That didn't go over very well. Everybody let me know, we don't want to cut anything. So later I say, what about raising taxes to pay for everything we want? That doesn't go over either. Which way do you want it?
I am not for tax increase, but I am for positive funding for our school system. I was brought to my attention that in 2014 and 15, that our beginning teachers made $1,273 more than a beginning teacher in Cleveland City. In the 2016-17 year, I was told that that increase will be $95. And I'm understanding that we have money that we're putting in reserve. And my question is, if we have some funds, why aren't we doing some things? And why aren't we rewarding some of our teachers? Because like I said, folks, earlier, the morale is really, really low. And not only do we need to reward the teachers, but we need to be sure that the students are getting the adequate supplies and materials that they need in the classroom.
Well, you asked a really big question for 60 seconds to answer. Are the education needs being met? Mr. Rose said the county commission determines what the funding level is. So as a school board, it's our job to live within our means. For the first time in a long time, we figured out how to do that. And that's meant doing without some things that we want and focusing on things that we need. But it's also meant bringing accountability, like a purchase order system, so that you can't buy a $500 desk lamp without putting your name on it and putting your budget on it. That kind of stuff stopped. And that's where $1.4 million, by the way, for the board members, it's not 820, it'll be 1.4 or higher, came from this budget year. As far as tax rates, 4 years ago, I sat up here at Lee and said, that's our biggest challenge. How do we do it without new taxes? The wheel tax was the big issue. We voted it down overwhelmingly. So our community has spoken about where we need to be and what we need to have. We've done more with less in Bradley County schools in the last 4 years than at any time in this history.
The idea that somehow this board is seemingly all of a sudden saved money is so far-fetched that I can hardly get my arm around it. Carter said we had 800,000 left. Chris says he has 1.4 million left. The budget is about 70 million. The state recommends that you retain 3% of your money. That would be 2.1 million. So we've done well, but every single, there's never been a year in Bradley history when the board spent 100% of its budget. They always save 1, 2, 3% for as long as the schools have been there. So there's nothing special about that. Now, I applaud what's being done, but when I was superintendent of schools, we added on 7 different campuses without a tax increase, and, you know, that just happened. That's history. Those are facts. Thank you.
What would you, in your capacity as a board member, we'll start with you. What would you, in your capacity as a member of the board, do to help improve teacher morale?
First thing I would do would restore some of the benefits taken to the teacher. For you ladies out there, the board recently took away teachers' maternity benefits. They couldn't take off 1 year without pay to be with their children. And that's 18 weeks. I've had several teachers that I know decided to leave the system. So we need to work on that. Pay increases would be a good thing, and that big pay increase that they mentioned was 10 cents an hour for veteran teachers. They want to talk about across the board for you. New teacher, it might have been 25 cents an hour. I don't know. And they say they pose the income back. Well, read the banner. It's right here. See what you think. Proposing a tax increase to Bill Lake Forest when it took less than 10 cents to do it. And Mr. Turner also supported that. Read it for yourself. You decide what you think about it. I'm opposed to it. And I'm just telling you, there's a lot of things we could do, a lot of things, and it does not always have to start out with us paying taxes. And we don't pay them anyway, the county commission does. But he proposed it. He can't do it, but he proposed it. Read it for yourself.
Anyway, what have we done to help teachers? What have we done? Okay. This is a resolution that was written to express lack of confidence in the Tennessee Education Assessment Model team to assess teacher effectiveness in the classroom. We changed that in Bradley County and went to a different evaluation at the request of Bradley County school teacher and the administrator. Resolution in opposition to any proposal whereby I wrote that. Resolution in opposition to any personnel proposal whereby teaching license is issued
renewed or denied based on results of Tennessee value-added assessment system, TVAS. That was in the law. This went before the state, went to the state legislature. It was adopted by the Tennessee school boards, and we fought it, and we beat it, and they changed it. The state is still having trouble with testing because there is no validity in the test they want to give.
Teachers, I'm speaking to you. Think of where we were 4 years ago with our Department of Education in the state of Tennessee. Were you happy with that department? Everything I heard was no. And this board stood up against that department, with Charlie's resolution and others. There's now been a change in that state department. If you've noticed, there's an entirely new director, Candace McQueen. This board has been part of that change and part of defending a teacher in the classroom.
I'm here in Bradford County 24/7. I'm available by email, telephone. You call me, I'll call you back. You send me a text, I will respond to it. You send me on the street, I will answer your questions. I'll be there. And the two schools that I would represent, although I would represent all the schools in the system, Hopewell and Prospect, I would want those teachers to feel that they could come to me with any problems they have. I would want those administrators to feel that they could come to me with any problems they have. I might not be able to solve all the problems, but I'd be a great sounding board in listening to those people because I'm here. I'm here in the community every day. And I do answer texts, as a lot of y'all can verify, and I do answer emails, and I do answer the phone, and I will return your calls if you call me. So I would encourage the teachers that if you have a situation, a problem, if you're unhappy, you need to let somebody know, and you need to let somebody know that can help you handle the situation instead of letting it fester and nothing good happen. Thank you.
Teacher morale, and a lot of talk about teachers. I'm the son of a teacher. There's nothing like being raised by a teacher. I'm married to a teacher. I hear it every single night. Her sister's a teacher. My brother was a teacher. His wife's a teacher. You see where this is going? Teacher morale is a major issue. Our teachers have been under attack for years because ultimately we've got special interests that want to dismantle public education. That's happened over and over and over again. And I got to tell you, I've talked to a lot of teachers, and a lot of them are very, very happy that our strategic plan has one of five major components, which is improving teacher morale. I and the other members of the board delivered cookies to the first district schools and the feeder schools. We went out and talked to teachers. We do that on a regular basis. Maybe some folks should get off Facebook and stop reading a very small group of people's comments and start talking to real teachers across the system about the changes and the progress that we've made.
One thing that you could do to improve morale of teachers is to try very, very, very hard to not reduce the number of teachers, which is happening in several schools. And I know kids don't come in bunches of 15 and 20. It just doesn't work that way. But almost many of our schools are experiencing a reduced number of teachers. Secondly, the teacher, and everybody's important, but the teacher is the most important employee in the school district. Kids are what it's about. Kids are the most important. Teachers are the most important employees. Everybody else should be a support person for teachers. From Dr. Cash, custodian, and everybody in between, we've got to work together. But the teachers are what it's about, and that needs to be a priority for everybody. Thank you.
Should the director of schools be elected or appointed?
Start with me over here. Obviously, I was elected twice. I like that very much because I could do what I thought was right, even if I didn't think the board thought it was right. Dr. Cash doesn't have that luxury. She's a wonderful lady, and they've gotten there off to a great start, and I hope to continue that. I loved, as an educator, being on the cutting edge and free to do what I thought was right for kids, whether my board agreed with it or not. My favorite thing to do was to get principals and board members in a room and let them argue for what they want. You know, I want the Oak Grove principal. If I had $1 million, I want him to tell me how to best be spent. I want the Charleston principal to tell me, the Michigan Avenue principal, and the board members. And then I can do what I thought was right, regardless. And as an employee board, obviously you work with the board, but obviously you better work with four of them effectively if you intend to stay long. So I think being elected has many advantages, but that's not going to happen, and that's not the world we're in, and I can certainly live with the one we're in. Thank you.
Mr. Frazier said that's not our decision. It's been decided, and I think the statistics are out there about the effectiveness of school systems that have appointed superintendents. And I've been asked this question for 4 years. 4 years ago, I was asked this question when I was running for office. This is one of those issues that it's not polar. It's not zero or 100. There's advantages, there's disadvantages, there's pros, there's cons. And on this one, I'll check out about 51-49. 51%, we ought to have an appointed superintendent. 49%, I believe that people should have a voice. That's why you can actually speak at a board meeting now. You couldn't do that 4 years ago. So I believe that you should have representation. I believe you should have those things. And that is, under state law today, you're elected school. So I support appointed superintendents. It opens up the pool of candidates. It allows us to get the best possible person, not just the best good old boy that grew up in Bradley County.
I think an elected school board, superintendent, director of schools, would be answerable to the public more so than an appointed. We're in a situation now where ours are as appointed. And that's what I think makes it so important to the school board that's elected, because we are your voice into what's going on. And the superintendent, director of schools is answerable to the school board. And that's the reason I think you should have a qualified board of education that's handling your suggestions, your comments, your needs, your wants in the community.
Appointed 100%. Elected means you just pick the best guy that's around the block, because you can only choose someone that's already resigned in Bradley County. Appointed means you can pick the best around the country. I selected Dr. Cash. If you have a problem with that decision, then don't vote for me.
Both of them have their pluses and their minuses. And I've had to come to grips with that since I've been on the board. I mentioned that when I started. I addressed the change of the role of the board has changed so very much because of the appointed superintendent. It places us as the buffer between the director of schools, where the politics is removed at least one step. If you don't like what's going on in the system, you can holler at the board members. You can scream at us. If we don't change it, then that's why we have elections. Folks, elections make a difference. The direction of this school board has been turned around and going in the right direction. We are for the community, and we want to be with the community.
As I said, I'm a Bradley County teacher. We've done well in the system. Ask your teachers if you think all things are well. Ask your teachers if they like the raise they got this year. They do not. Now, let me clarify this to everybody. Dr. Cash, I met her 2 or 3 times, a wonderful lady, doing an excellent job in whatever kind of situation. Dr. Cash, no matter who wins the election, don't have anything to worry. She's got a job. If I'm on the board, and I'm sure these people would put her there, I'm sure with her they do. And I'm going to tell you, too, I was supposed to get rid of Johnny Daniel, too, though. So, go figure. But, personally, being an educator, I've seen what four board members can do and how they can run the system, okay? I personally am for elected superintendent because I don't think people are stupid. I don't think the board's stupid. I'd rather have a lot of people elected. And yes, it might be some problems up in Bradley County. Why not? Why do we have to go out of town always to get somebody to be our leader? Even though Dr. Cash is one, and we've had some ones, both in the city and in county. Thank you.
Starting from this end, are you in favor of legislation that would allow full-time faculty and staff to carry concealed weapons on campus?
That's something that I would consider. The Sheriff's Department does an excellent job. They have an SRO at every school. I'm not opposed to it being studied and said it's safety. I don't think every teacher should carry a gun. I know a lot of people, I wouldn't want to carry a gun. But there are people in this school who are playing and other things. Now, I'm not saying I'm endorsing it. I'm just saying it's something we need to study. I would talk to our good sheriff. He knows as much as anybody how important it would be. And maybe instead of getting people carry a gun, maybe they need to give us two SROs at every school. So they can, we get rich, they can take schools, they're professors. And that's one thing. I'm not kidding, I'm not hoping anybody in here carrying a gun. Nobody. I'm just saying, I don't know if I want to run around the classroom. My first grade teacher, kindergarten teacher. I just don't know. I'll have to study that a whole lot.
I may be incorrect, but I think the gentleman helped write this bill. He put it in place, standing in the back door in 1913 and 2013. So, the best I can see of that law, is we see on the signs of all our schools, no firearms allowed. What does that say to people that walk the street and want to do harm to some children? So I think one of the strengths of the law, if there would be a strength, was the fact that the people that may want to do harm to students are coming to a school. They do not know if there are individuals been there with firearms or not. They know the police officer, the SRO. And we're very fortunate in this county to have SROs in our schools. Every one of them. We're very fortunate. We're blessed.
If you're ex-military, ex-law enforcement, and you're teaching in our schools or working in our schools, why shouldn't you carry a gun? Our kids need to be protected at all costs. We have SROs, but we have one per school. That's stretched pretty thin when you look at some of the large middle schools and high schools we have. But if you've been to Afghanistan, you've been to Iraq, you protected my freedom over there, my God, you should be able to carry a gun. Protect it here.
I would have to say that I'm all for carry permits and guns. I'm trying to get my carry permit right now, matter of fact. And I'm not really sure that as a classroom teacher, I would want to have a gun on me. I would hope that my SRO would be there to take care of the situation. I would also hope that I would be able to, if I had to have a gun, that I could do it. But folks, not everybody in this world, even though they go to a firing range and get qualified with a gun, is capable of having a gun on a campus. And I think those are some things that we would have to look at. And as long as we have our SROs, and as long as we have qualified people to handle situations, and I'm not talking about with a gun, I think we're probably better off, although I would not be opposed if someone did have a carry permit and I felt confident that that person could handle the situation. I think it'd be okay.
Just to clarify, you're asking me if I want my wife to carry a gun to school. So let's put real names and real faces on that question. Representative Watson at the time introduced that bill. And it was an issue because across the state, and I've had the pleasure of working with board members all over Tennessee. And I don't think you people understand how blessed we are in Bradley County. Because we have an SRO at every county school all the time. No questions asked. You don't believe me, try speeding in front of a school. That stuff stopped. We also had the DARE program back because Sheriff Watson put it back. We've got support of law enforcement in our schools. But to give every teacher who has a concealed carry permit, which is the safe and effective possession of a gun, versus training every single full-time faculty member on how to handle every single situation that could ever arise with. If you hadn't seen some of our football players, they're 6'10", 400-pound boys. I don't know that we necessarily need guns around every single student in every single school.
You don't think one of mine is bad to take the teacher's gun away?
My point.
Sorry. Our schools are, we have a safety plan, we have a safety director, we have the SROs that everybody's alluded to. The school doors are locked except for the first entrance, and most of the time if you go after the schools take up, you have to pass by an SRO to get in the building. So I think our schools are safer than they've ever been. The call systems for classrooms to contact the office are better than they've ever been. I'm not opposed to people with permits carrying guns. Obviously, I think if you were the principal, you would want to be selective about who on your staff that was, and you might not want, you certainly wouldn't want to force people to do that.
All right, unfortunately, that brings us to the end of our questioning. We will now end this group with a 90-second closing statement. Each of you, and we'll start over here with Richard.
Okay, I would like to thank Adam and the committee and everybody for turning out tonight. It's been fun and enlightening. A couple things. I do think that Bradley County has welcomed people to their schools forever, and the public, contrary to what's been said up here, has always been able to address the Board of Education. The difference, the only difference is now, before, is that you have to give later notice. I think now you can sign up 30 minutes before the meeting or something. And used to, you had to sign up the day before or 2 days before or something, whatever the pleasure of the board was at the time. So the public has always been able to address the board. The money saving is something that's been done every single year. I think, again, back to the energy level, I think that's important. I think a history of service and leadership in the community is important. I've been involved in Rotary, Ruritan. I served on the boards of the United Way, the Junior Achievement, the Keep America Beautiful, the Girl Scout Council, the Chamber of Commerce, the YMCA, Keep America, on and on. So I've been on lots and lots of boards and enjoyed the service and gave lots of service and look forward to serving again on the Board of Education. Thank you very much.
Again, thank you to the Republican Party and all of you who hung in here with us for such heated, literally, debate and discussion. We've had a lot of change in the last 4 years. Contrary to Mr. Frazier's statement, nobody ever spoke to the Board of Education because it never got through the director's office. That changed. You can bring anything you want to the board every meeting. 4 years ago, there used to be a sunshine law violating preview where you were told how you're going to vote. Today, that doesn't happen. Every single meeting is recorded and posted online so that anybody, anywhere in the world can watch it. 4 years ago, our principals were instructed to use taxpayer property to put a sign up that said, vote yes for the wheel tax. And we now have a state law that prevents anywhere in the state happening what happened here in Bradley County. 4 years ago, we used to plan to spend more money than we actually did. And I got to argue with Mr. Frazier. There was an awful lot of spending, not a whole lot of saving in the previous 10 years. 4 years ago, we had a director of schools that was determined to spend us into a tax increase. Roofs that leaked, gym floors ruined, windows falling out. Today, we've expanded Walker Valley. We started Lake Forest this fall. We're investing in technology for students. Believe it or not, we actually pay our teachers much higher than the state minimum schedule. And you can't fund, you can't spend what's not funded. 4 years ago, Common Core had taken hold of the state of Tennessee. We had private meetings here with the Department of Education and our own Chamber of Commerce tried to force it down our throats. The repeal of Common Core started here in Bradley County. 4 years ago, my opponent had my sign in her yard. She voted for me. But apparently, she didn't like the kind of changes that we brought to our school system. I'll keep defending conservative Republican values. I'll keep defending Bradley County. I'll make sure taxpayers get what they paid for. I'll continue to focus on strategic planning, and I'll put students first. I'm Chris Turner. I'm running for the school board. I'll do whatever you need me to do to focus on our future. Let's keep moving forward. We certainly can afford to go back.
And Chris is right. I did support him last time. I did have a sign in my yard, and I also sent him an email back about, 6 to 8 months ago, maybe longer than that, and told him why I would not do that again. And I think he's aware of that. But the only response I got to that email, I copied it to all the board, was from another board member who is no longer on the board. I would like to say that our schools consist of four walls, and those are what hold the future of Bradley County. So I'm running for a seat on the Bradley County School Board because I want to ensure our future. I want to ensure that it's protected, preserved, and provided for. And in addition, I intend to bring leadership to the board with the spirit of cooperation, collaboration, and mostly respect, folks. And I want to thank Adam and the group tonight for having this meeting. I think it's been wonderful. I want to thank all of you all sitting out there fanning yourselves now with all the campaign literature. Y'all have been great, and I do appreciate it. Thank you so much.
It's not often that I get city school board and city council in a room with me at the same time, so I'm going to use this 90 seconds to ask a favor. We're trying to improve all the schools across Bradley County, save energy, and fix our windows and our AC units, and change all these systems out. We've got a plan to do it without a tax increase. We've got a way to finance it through the energy savings that would be realized from this program. All we need you to do is say yes. Say you'll let the county do this. Let the school system itself have its own operating budget, pay for it, and be reimbursed for the energy savings. We need you to let that bond issue go. We will be doing a bond for Lake Forest. We know the county commission is going to issue one for that. You will get your money on that issue, on that bond issue. That's going to be coming from the county commission, from the general sources of revenue. But this program is going to be done straight from our budget. This is what I've been working for the last 4 years. I've tried to cut programs. I've tried to raise taxes. This is the way to do it. We have found a solution. Every school is going to get new windows. Have you seen the ones at North Lee where my son goes? The rain comes right in through the windows in gym class, floods the floor. This is happening all over our schools. Our heat and air systems are 40 years old in some buildings. It changes all of that. Please, councilmen, city school board members, let us do this. I have actually made motions to drop the liquors tax suit. I think we can make a compromise on that. I think we should let that one go, and I think you should let us have this one program that would fix all our schools at once.
I do just want to thank everyone for staying. Hopefully the energy program that we have in place, we're planning to do. When you come back to the county commission, they're involved also. We got in agreement with the county commission. Maybe it'll be cooler in here. Maybe you all can relax and enjoy it. But anyway, I want to say this. When I think about the many things on the horizon for our system, I can only summarize it by saying, I can visualize a variety of ways to meet individual needs by creating educational opportunities for children. And that's what I want to do. If I am not a supporter of education and believe in education, I've wasted my life. I spent close to 50 years in Brandon County schools fighting for our children. And I will continue to do what I can to fight for children and teachers to get the funding we need. We're in a very unique situation in Brandon County and Cleveland City. If Brandon County was funded the way the city is funded, we would get millions of dollars more a year, and not a single million. Also, I want to say about the turnover of the way it used to operate on the budget. This board put into place budget safeguards so that any money spent at the end of a school year was not rolled over into the next school year budget. Therefore, we have savings. Before it was automatically rolled over, the board knew not where the money was going until we saw the presentation of the budget.
First, I'd like to remind people that do not know, I served on experience under six superintendents and director of school. First, Mr. Walker, who hired me. I served under Jerry Frager, Dr. Nair, David Holloway, Bob Taylor, Johnny McDaniel. I served under all of them. They were all different. And I learned, like I did in the military, if I got a new leader, I learned to get along. If I don't like the president, I'm going to have to learn to get along with him. That's another story. I oppose Common Core. Obviously, my opponent does not know me. He's never known me. My teachers will tell you I opposed it from the start. Probably wasn't the first people to stand up. Anybody knows me at Oak Grove School, tell you, I'm not afraid to stand up to anybody. My mama taught me that. And she also told me, son, from the Bible and from one of her favorite people, even though she wouldn't have voted for the Kennedys, Miss Kennedy, she said, to whom much is given, much is expected. And she said, the harder you work, the more you'll make. And then you need to give more. And I learned that also from Reverend Littlefield. Didn't go to his church, but I learned it from him. And the part about speaking at the board meetings, that's not true. That's just not true. I spoke at the board meetings when they were trying to get on me, not for putting up a sign. I didn't put up a sign about tax rate that Mr. Rose and some others wanted. I didn't put it up in the director's school budget. I had a sign on my car for a friend. Like many of you had Bush signs or Carter signs or whatever. I had one up. They wanted me to tell me I couldn't. Our lawyer said that was a violation of my right of freedom of speech. And so they had to stop it. I took it off as a personal favor to the director of school. Thank you.
Well, we've reached the conclusion of our final group tonight. Before we thank him, I want to make a couple of quick announcements. As has been said, early voting does begin July 15th, and election day, of course, on August the 4th. The Bradley County Election Commission is in need of election officials to help work the polls on August office for it. If you or someone you know is interested in more details, you can contact the Brown County Election Commission. If you're in attendance tonight and are interested, we do have some applications as well as some more information here at the front. I would like to thank the Thuma Daily Banner, the Chattanooga Times Free Press, Mix 104.1, 101.3 The Buzz, and WTMU for their participation tonight, as well as the candidates. If we could give all these folks a round of applause for the city.